Hey guys, it's Serge, and I'm here to do an extended gaming test for you guys. So essentially what this means is I'm gonna play this game and I'm gonna see if I can actually do a decent job. At the same time, I'm also gonna be playing for a really long time. So it'll be three videos. I'm gonna be playing non-stop, and I'm gonna try to see if I can get this MacBook Air to overheat, if I can get it to crash. Just overall, I'm gonna give you guys my general thoughts and opinions on this device and how it plays these particular types of games. A lot of people online are convinced that you can't play games on the MacBook Air series. While I'm playing one of the most intensive, games out there right now, and I actually do a pretty decent job.
Okay, so here I am in game. Let's see how well we can do. Playing on the MacBook Air 2015 edition. I do have some upgrades on this MacBook, but it won't really matter what the upgrades are because this game doesn't really take advantage of those upgrades. So even the base model will perform this well. So, see what we can do here. So it looks like we've pushed him into the last point. And from what I can tell, it looks like on the MacBook Pro, you're getting about 5, maybe 10 FPS more. Based on me just running through the map, I can tell that even at the same graphical settings, you're not getting as good performance. And again, this probably has something to do with the Iris Pro in the MacBook Pro and the HD 6000 in the MacBook Air. Occasionally, the HD 6000 does perform better, but I haven't really been able to figure out why. It seems that the HD 6000 is more stable, and that could be due to all kinds of odd reasons. Who knows why? Maybe the cooling is better for it. Who knows? Most likely not, though, because the fan is bigger on the MacBook Pro. All right, let's see how well we can do. So, okay, let's see how good we can do while we're flying. All right, so some things to note. The laptop does get somewhat hot, especially when you're pressing down the W key, but it's not hot enough to burn you. And I have never had this laptop overheat, which is what a lot of people ask me. Ask me, does it overheat? Basically, what I'm gonna tell you is no, it doesn't, so. Don't worry about it overheating or anything like that. Ooh. I'm gonna circle this point here. Ooh. Jump out. That's pretty much all the points. Ooh, that was close. Oh, I got him. Yeah. That's badass. For a second, I was like, oh, I got close at least. But no, I actually got him. Just in time to win. Not bad. Not bad at all. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play the game for another round, and I wanna see if I can get the computer to crash just by playing the game. And I also wanna see how well I can do in the server in comparison to everybody else. Because a lot of times people say, well, sure, it can run the game, but can you enjoy it? And can you actually do well? So I'm gonna basically show you some of the strats that I've used while playing this game in the past, and yeah, we'll see how well it runs. So let's take a look here. All right. So the fan definitely ramps up in the first couple minutes of gameplay, and to me that's normal. I mean, that's gonna happen. So One thing I did want to try, which I'll probably try next round, is I did get a laptop cooler. And I want to show you guys if the laptop cooler actually helps your game performance and if it's worth having. That's another thing we will be talking about. Okay, so right now we're going to play Conquest Operation Riverside. See how well we do on this map. I think we're having about maybe 32 players. We'll see, because we didn't have quite a lot of people leave earlier. So, well, same map, I guess. All right, I'm going to get the attack chopper. I'm the first one in it. Oh, this is a different map. Never mind. That's one of those linear maps. Okay, so we're down to about 20-something players, but more will probably join. So I still want to see how far I can get playing this game. What's this guy shooting at? Oh, got enemy chopper. Heads up. Oh, I should have waited to pop my other... Okay, he got us. Did our gunner even do any damage on this guy? Our gunner missed every single shot. That's pretty pathetic. Okay, we'll see if we can do better. I'm going to switch for the Stinger missile, just in case I do need to jump out. And, yeah, I guess we'll see what kind of vehicles we can get here. Motorcycle, yeah, that'll probably do. Might as well cap some points along the way. Ooh. Let's see here. Oops. Ugh. Oh my goodness, I'm a bad driver. So a lot of my subscribers were asking me to do this because they essentially still like playing Battlefield 3. And they want to get more out of Battlefield 3 before they even move on to Battlefield 4. And it's pretty amazing that people still play this game because it actually is still a pretty fun game. Okay. Oh shit. Ah, should not have driven in the center of battle. That was bad. Alright, next time I'm going to go on the side. Okay, we're kind of lagging a little bit too. That's fine. Alright, next time I'm going to wait for this guy to pop his smoke before I fire at him. I might just fire one missile at him though. See if that does any damage. I miss all my shots? Yeah, it looks like it. You know what I'm gonna do? Probably seat switch. Uh-oh. Cancel. Okay, there we go. Is that even an enemy? There's an enemy plane. Is that gonna be enough to kill him? Well, he disappeared, so I hope so. We got some tanks. Missing my shots, but I'm hitting right in front of him. So let's see if we can get him. Alright, backing up. Backing up, backing up, backing up. Alright, get behind these trees. Oh no. Oh, jump out. I have somebody on our tail. I thought maybe it was somebody on the, maybe like a ground troop or something. Damn. Still got me in either way. Okay, well, in that case, let's spawn woods, go on foot for now. We're not doing too good. Except I don't have my RPG. Probably want to give me a quick go. This guy knows what he's doing. That's good. Alright, another tank, bro. Heads up. He's out. Oh, been shot out already. Alright, we do have a chopper coming up headway here. See if we can take him out. Really sucking at this game. Everybody left too. That kind of sucks. This is a fun map though. Would have liked to play this some more. I probably should stick to the tank. Alright, well, after this, I'll probably will. I'm gonna get right behind him. He's not gonna see me. And I'm going to unload on him. I'm not even going to wait to lock on him yet. Okay, it looks like he's already shooting at me. Oh, fuck, looks like I'm not going to make it. Where am I being shot from? Alright. Alright, let's see how far we can get. Ooh. Capping it, nobody's even here. I got 66 going on. Gotta get under the cover here. That would even protect me against the chopper. Probably not. Oh, we got almost all the points. What do you know? Except for that one there. That's one of ours. Yeah, enemy chopper behind us. See if I can get him like last time. Close. Really close. Woo! Got two enemy choppers now. What, these guys get in range? Really close. I'm gonna have to join a more populated server. Yeah, most likely. There's not enough players on here anyway. Let me try one more shot on this thing.
So I played the game for about 14 something minutes, and it's doing pretty good. I'm not running into any major freezing or glitching or anything. Let's take a look at part two and see if I can get it to glitch up. And see, maybe my performance just starts to drop even more. Because on a lot of these laptops, people are saying, and I've even expected this myself, that the laptop will throttle, the performance will start to go down. Let's see if that actually happens in part two. Let's go. Click here.
That is the trail in northern Pennsylvania. Just rock, rock, and fucking rock. It cuts you down to about half speed, and it's really fucking annoying. But that's life on the trail. It gets better after you get into New Jersey, but yeah, it's fucking... For you potential yellow blazers out there next year, if you're going to yellow blaze anywhere, make it northern Pennsylvania. I swear.
Wow. It's kind of cold out. How weird is that? It's Thursday morning, July 23rd. I'll be in Delaware Water Gap today. Going to hang out there. See about getting Rose up here. It's been a little quiet lately. I've noticed this every year. After Harper's Ferry, kind of, people just, we get spread out. And a lot of the people who were just out having fun are gone. I think they say about 50% are off the trail by Harper's Ferry. So I didn't see a single hiker yesterday. And as far as I know, nobody's come to the shelter here. Strange like that. But hopefully I'll see some people. I know I got Scout, I think his new name's Sledge. Sledge is waiting for me in Delaware Water Gap, and tonight's a hiker feed. I made the one in 2013, I'll definitely video that. But yeah, trail has been strange this year. I have taken my last two oxy. Weird how that always works. When I get some pain pills like that, I take them for fun, and then right towards the end, anyway, my left shoulder is really messed up. I felt it when I was putting my pack on sometime yesterday. It's going to be hurting for a while. It's kind of unusual. It's usually something to do with my legs or feet. They're fine right now, but I am sore. The rocks of Pennsylvania, you work muscles you don't normally do through your legs because you're going this way and that. The freaking rocks, man. I would have showed you more of them, but I need both my hands on my hiking poles to do that. Anybody wants to sponsor me with a GoPro for next year, I would definitely take one. But, man. But I do remember, I skipped this section last year, Yellow Blaze passed it, but I do remember 13, that as you get into New Jersey, the rocks kind of lighten up some, and there's some cool stuff in Jersey. So I'm kind of strange. I'm kind of waiting for it to warm up a little bit out there. Weird. Weird weather, but it ain't raining. And I ain't, up until about 2 days ago, every day I was just soaking wet in sweat. And man, glad that's a little better.
And what is your trail name?
Snake Man.
And when did you hike?
April 7th, trail days.
Cool.
Yeah.
You got a trail name?
No, not yet.
Okay.
This is Teresa. Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah. Pocahontas, we'll call her for now.
That's not a bad. That's not bad. Not bad.
Yeah.
Well, like I say, I'm going to yellow skip these last 6 miles of freaking rocks and get into the Delaware Water Gap. Figure out what I'm going to do about Rose and see about conducting some safety meeting things there. And I'm wondering if I should use my real name though at the church hostel. I wonder if that was, the word got up to there too. You know, remember how I wasn't allowed in the Doyle? I think I'm going to tell them my name is Three. Freaking spider bite, man. Dang. Big spider, small spider?
I have no idea. I didn't even feel it.
Jeez.
Took it to the emergency room yesterday.
I know last year I've not seen four or five hikers with like a golf ball sized lump on them somewhere from a damn spider bite, man. Freaking spiders.
And I didn't even get a mutant power out of the deal.
True. Can do everything a spider can. Which I always thought was crazy. Well, this is Delaware Water Gap. I'm going to be hanging out here a couple days at least. Got some more oxy. Ain't a lot to do here. We have a hiker feed night at the church hostel. But there really isn't anything to do here. That's no problem. I know how to do nothing. This is a cool place. They got ice cream and it's a real bakery. They make all kinds of great stuff here. And the special, I remember when it was $1.50, but $2.95 isn't bad. Apple pie and a hot dog. Man. That's the outfitters here in Delaware Water Gap. Not too bad an outfitters. And then of course, up the hill is the hostel. Oh, these towns on the hills. Give me a nice level place. If you've hiked the trail for a while, you really appreciate level. Not even open, I don't think. Sounds like a place for hiker trash. Here with Sledge Scout, you remember him from like very beginning of the freaking documentary, one of the first hikers I met. He's here. God damn it. Pull out the fucking camera and a fucking truck's gotta fucking come by every fucking time. What's up, man?
Same old, just trying to do this. Trying to do this there, Mr. Seven. Yeah. What do I push? The back?
Nothing, it's already gone.
Hey, this is Seven sitting next to the big bad bear here in Delaware Water Gap.
Well, it's almost hiker feed time. Really close now. I've been at this one a couple of times over the years. It's usually pretty good. Not too many hikers here. Should be plenty to eat.
But these are plus underwear, huh?
You guys hungry?
Yes.
Hungry?
No,
hungry?
I'm starving.
Nothing like a hiker feed. Friday morning, July 25th, here at the Church of the Mountain Hostel. Gonna chillax here another day, see what happens this weekend.
And then we need to get that breakfast sandwich. What are you talking about? The breakfast sandwich at the apple pie shop.
You know, I remember when it was only $1.50. You got the pie and the hot dog for $1.50, but $2.95 is still a good deal.
Yeah, it's just a weird combination.
Oh, that's a cool place. They got way more than, they got ice cream. I remember.
You want a hot dog and a slice of pie.
One of my best memories.
Kind of a weird thing to ask.
One of my best memories on the trail is getting a ice cream, strawberry shortcake ice cream sundae there in 2010.
You remember that, huh?
I haven't been on, well, yeah, some food stand. I remember the time in my first hike, I ran out of food. I didn't have any more. I wouldn't be in the town till the next day, and I roll up on a shelter, and there's a can of spaghetti. So.
What?
I still remember how good they tasted. But
so
I wouldn't eat it now.
No,
yeah. Yeah. People who have never really been hungry don't understand that.
Nope.
And I don't mean that you miss lunch and you can't wait for dinner. I mean going, well, I've been homeless a couple times, so I know what hunger is. Well, I'm heading out of Delaware Water Gap. Let's cross the big bridge here, being Joyce-y.
Well, it's Saturday morning, July 25th. I'm in Jersey.
They'll
get me a white beater t-shirt, man. But yeah, this is the park right after the bridge. I usually stop there and get high. It's kind of a tradition of mine. Safety meeting. Sunfish Pond. Freaking place is full of tourists. I hope they don't come to the north end. Didn't really want to go any farther. We'll see. Anyway, I'm on the trail. It's a great place to get over things. It's a good day, not too hot. Hopefully it's not gonna rain or nothing. I'm gonna go to the Mohican Outdoor Center. I feel like I should, maybe I've been there. See, I skipped this section last year. This is when me and Shonigan hung with his friend Pistol Pete, who was in a rock band. We hung out at the bar in Jersey. So that's what I'm doing today. Scout is back there. He'll catch up. Funny, Scout and Cinderella were the first two hikers I actually met on the trail when I yellow blazed from the kickoff with Miss Janet up to Gooch Gap. Weird. As far as I can remember, I don't think I've ever went to this Mohican Outdoor Center. It's run by the AMC. I think I will. I'm in no hurry today. I'm just drifting. So it's 4/10 up this road. I'll give it a shot. Hell, for a cold Coca-Cola, I'll walk up there for it. But yeah, I don't think I've ever been there. I skipped this section last year, so my memory is not the greatest here in Jersey. That's the Mohican Outdoor Center. I remember being here, I think it was 2010. Not bad. I mean, you know, it's a little pricey, tourist prices, but they got sodas and, you know, snacks and sandwiches. So, yeah, it's worth coming up here, 4/10. I love this kind of shit. Just standing here, taking a smoke break, looking down the valley, all the houses, and what they're all doing down there. I love living outdoors. Thought my hiking poles were going down the cliff, but they didn't. I was saying, oh yeah, I love living outdoors until it gets cold. Man, I remember this section. There's a lot of views like this. I've said it before. If you're thinking about doing a through hike, and you can put up with a little pain and misery, man, do it. You'll love it. You'll love it. Just don't get obsessed with your miles. Don't miss out. Times like this really aggravate me when I want to make it just a short day. But I like a lot of water when I camp, so water, no legal place to camp. Plenty of fucking places to camp, but no fucking water. So you're not supposedly allowed to camp to this next section. It's another 4.4 miles for the next campsite and water that I see in the guidebook. Didn't really feel like doing another 4.4. Fuck. It's annoying. You're in the fucking woods with a tent, but you can't stop when you want to stop. Oh well. That's my problem. My addiction to water forces me to camp by water. What the fuck? I don't know what the fuck I'm saying. Take two. Yeah, it looks like I'm going to have to do another 4.4 miles. Water, good water source here, but no legal place to camp. I know. Nobody comes along. Gee. Legal. Sunday night, July 26th. Trail's quiet. The thru hikers are all pretty much spread out now, and trail is quiet. For all of those who knew who think the trail is too crowded and all that, I told you after Harper's Ferry, things have a way of quieting down. Nobody else is camped here tonight. I don't know if Scout's going to make it this far or not. It's really the only place to camp. Water, legal campsite. Anyway, that's what's going on. I'm sure some stuff will happen. I'm going to be out here at least the month of August, and there'll be more good stuff. Monday morning, July 27th. Trail's been quiet. We're all spread out now. I'd like to get with some of my hiker trash friends, but God knows where the hell they're at. Scout didn't make it to where I stopped last night. See if he comes by. I'm still glad I'm here. I was hurt by someone who I thought was a close friend this weekend, and it's bothered me, but I'll get past it. One thing about the trail, you never know really what's gonna happen. I hope my karma's evened out some now, and maybe I'll get some good karma coming up. I could really use that. Get some town food today, Branchville, New Jersey's on my route, and an in and out. And I know a shortcut by taking Sunrise Mountain Road. So. If it doesn't rain, it should be a halfway decent hiking day. And actually gonna probably stay at a shelter tonight. I don't know why there's a huge gap, like 30 miles with no shelters. Weird. Again, this state, New Jersey, where there are no fires anytime on the AT. I don't get that.
Thank you very much.
Same with Connecticut. Well, anyway, I'm gonna pack up. Finish my coffee. I got a hell of a good buzz. Jeez. I do enjoy pain pills. Sure does make hiking a lot easier. Alright, that's it. I will find some more video. I do want to, if I can get a couple of the right people together, I want to go into New York for a day with a camera. Times Square, do all that shit. Hiker trash out in New York City. That would be great. Jersey does have a lot of bears. Saw a bear yesterday. Now I just had a mama bear and cub cross the trail in front of me about 50 yards. Couldn't get the camcorder out in time, of course. Fucking Joyzy, man. Don't worry about bears. They run away. Well, that's another fucking shelter. I think it's Tuesday morning, maybe the 30th of July. Spider showed up in the middle of the night. They got a car. So we're off to new adventures. Fuck, I don't know. I've been on Oxy now for a week. Nothing like an Oxy for breakfast, let me tell you. And then a safety meeting, only way to hike. Yeah.
So I threw it and they break down. I called them up and they were like,
yeah.
Who makes those? Sweater, who makes those?
Five Fingers.
So this is the representative for Five Fingers. Fucking
and I fucking love them.
You didn't know what they were getting into.
That's awesome.
And so now every time they break down, I call them up and they're like, hey. You don't have to get a new pair. We'll just send you, where are you going to be at 5 days from now?
Depends on where we're hitchhiking to.
True. Yellow blazing has its drawbacks.
I said that last year. Yeah, yellow blazing has its problems. Sometimes you get ahead of yourself. You know, I yellow blazed past my bounce box last year.
Yeah, yeah.
Ian, what is your trail name?
Naffles.
And when did you hike?
Last year, 2014.
Oh, you do a through hike?
Kinda.
Close enough.
Close enough. Close enough.
You were the last ones out last
year. I was out until like December 7th.
Well, we're here in Barnon, New Jersey, pit stop. See what's up. Well, we're at this church hostel in Barnon. I've never been here before. Spider says it's cool and chilled out, so we'll find out. Give me a chance to get cleaned up. I am a little funky. Man, it's been so humid lately. You just get on the trail and you're just soaked in sweat. All my gear's getting a little funky at this point. All right, this is the end of the video from the camcorder I lost. I'll tell you how I lost it. Me and Spider and Butcher, we all got to that hostel in Vernon, New Jersey. And it's a great hostel. I love the place. But the night we were there, they were having a AA meeting. So Spider and Butcher went out to this bar and grill and ate. And they told me that they had a trivia game going in the bar. And they won because they were cheating using their phones, and Spider won a $20 gift card. So I forget what happened to Butcher, but the next day, me and Spider, we go to this damn restaurant. We burn up the $20 gift card. I notice my SD card's about full, change it out. We go outside. First ride picks us up hitching. We go about 15 miles away. I get out of the damn ride. We get on the trail. I don't have my camcorder anymore. This is when I started using the Kindle Fire. There's not a lot on there. You know, I'll show what I got. Really sorry about the video quality of the thing this year. It really sucks. I mean, I'm slightly OCD in having my entire 2015 through hikers slightly out of focus. Really fucking bothers me. I hope to do a lot better job in 2016. I've got a great idea coming up in January. It's going to be a really good video. The best information on how to hike, through hike the Appalachian Trail I've ever done. I don't want to say what yet because I don't want anybody copying me. I hope next year I want to do more in-depth interviews with more interesting hikers and see what I can come up with. I sure appreciate all the help with the GoFundMe. If you could continue to help me, that would be great. Anyway, it's January 1st here in the backwoods of Florida, where I'm living in my tent until March. Hope to see you all out on the trail. Thanks for watching. Like I say, sorry about the video quality. I guess I can't get out of 1040. Say something, Spider.
What's going on?
Yeah, I lost my camcorder today. Testing this out, this is what I'll be using for the rest of the trip, I guess. I hope this looks better at home than it does right now. It looks a little shaky. As I've said, I've lost my camcorder. I'm gonna have to finish up using my Kindle Fire tablet. Me and Spider, we tested out some mushrooms I've had since like freaking Waynesboro. They're in capsules made in Colorado, already measured out. We have determined that one apiece is okay, but to really get high, two to three would be better. But I'll be experimenting with that. I don't know, there hasn't been a lot going on. The trail's pretty quiet. At the shelter, hoping some women will show up, but it ain't happening. Today, I'm just trying to make it to Harriman State Park and either camp right before or, I don't know, down by the beach where the trail crosses. I hope to get you some more good video. I am concerned. You know, I lost the camcorder, but I just put in another SD card before I lost it. which had the backups of 2013, 2014 True Hikers videos and my music backup. But I think I might have lost a 32 gigabyte card that had about 10% video on it. I'm not sure. I don't really have any way to check. Sorry if I've lost some video. I'm real sure I've got the early stuff, which was the best stuff. So what's the plan, man?
Seven Lakes Drive will take you straight to Bear Mountain, that map says.
Nice. How far, I wonder?
This didn't
look like a good hitchhiking crowd. Well, me and Spider are going to take a mushroom trip. We got to about 9 miles on this Seven Lake Drive road to get to Bear Mountain. I really don't want to walk it, but the type of people here are not the type that are going to give us a ride, at least not in my opinion. Well, me and Spider are here at Fort Montgomery. It's like nothing's really here. A couple of restaurants, iffy, but this gas station's always here. We took the two calves of mushrooms. I'm not feeling them as much as I should. Maybe I hung on to them too long. Kind of feel it. I realize we're only 6 miles from Braymore, but it's a fucked up 6 miles. So I try to. Can't really hitch around here. See what's happening. It'd be nice to get a ride over there. I know, man. Hey, you guys think the trail's packed all the time? Well, after Harper's Ferry, it really slows down out here. El Mundo heading out Fort Montgomery, but yeah, there's hardly any real hiker trash around. They're all over the fucking place. Maybe they'll show up at Braymore like last year. Alright, let's see about maybe getting some barbecue, I think. Spider! Come over here out of the sun, son. Tell us what just happened, man.
We got a ride from a tweaker. He dropped us off on the side of the interstate, on the wrong side of town, in the hood. It was horrible. Thank goodness for cab companies.
Well, we're here at my favorite market, the Appalachian Trail Market. They have everything. But the best part is the Braymore Life Center is just a half a mile from here, half a trail mile. Yeah, like Spider said, man, Tweaker let us out in the middle of freaking nowhere, trying to Peekskill. Fortunately, I had enough cash to take a taxi. It would have been fucked up if we hadn't.
Not bad. And they're like, you know, we'll sit here.
Yeah, we'll send you a pair to try out. If you like them, tell people about them. I'm like, cool. They started breaking. I called them up. I'm like, hey, these shoes that you sent me for free are breaking. They're like, where are you going to be at in a week? We'll send you another pair. Yeah, free shoes for the trail the whole way.
Yeah, that's what they did for me whenever my started going bad. I just said that again.
All of them, though.
Well, I'm at the Graymore Life Center, one of my favorite places. They usually leave you alone here. Although, I have been here on weekends where they've had weddings and shit, and it gets a little messy. Hopefully none this weekend. We'll see what's happening. I'm still getting used to using my Kindle Fire for my video. Takes good pictures, though. And I miss my camcorder. Wednesday, Saturday morning, about 10:30. I was going to hang out at the Graymore Life Center a day or two, but run some huge picnic here with like 500 people and take your chances here on the weekend. Yeah, well, we're allowed to stay, but I just don't want to. No, not what I want to do. So I'm going to be out here for the month of August. I'm going to take my time, just head out and find me a camp spot today. So, your trail name again?
Pretty Fry.
What's for the audience? Your trail name again?
Pretty Fry.
And what have you been up to?
Where's the camera?
You guys are still hanging together, huh? Got Ghost over here.
Ghost on Lebowski.
King of fun.
Got new tents.
Queen of danger.
Got new tents, huh?
Yeah, I traded it. New
tent. Judy is great. I love Lightheart tents.
Go, Lightheart. Judy.
I wish I had one.
You got Henry Shire, though. He's good, too.
Let's see, it's, man, there's the camera. It's on that side. It's, Sunday morning, August the 2nd. Just hiking, taking my time. Ghost was here yesterday. Scout got ahead of me, way ahead of me. I'm going to have to call him today. And I'm thinking I might wind up at the RPH shelter. I had video of that last year. Wish I had my camcorder. Using the Kindle Fire is strange. But that's what's going on. Well, I'm at the this barn, Clarence Fuck State, whatever the fuck the name of this park is, at the beach. First time I've taken the Blue Blaze down the concession. They call it point .2, it's not point .2, it's more like point .4. $2.50 for a Pepsi, what are you going to do? Anyway, I hit the RPH shelter tonight. That was in my documentary last year. Later, people. And what is your hiker name?
I'm Snack.
Why are you hiking the AT?
Maximum fun.
Cool, man. What's your trail name?
I'm BC.
And why are you hiking?
For an adventure.
Cool, thanks. There's a street sign. Down in Whiskey Canyon. Monday morning, August 3rd. A lot of people here at the RPH last night. I'm heading to the deli. That's my next goal. The Stormville Deli. That's what's going on anyway. Later. I might have a camcorder coming from a Facebook friend. That'd be cool. Those of you who don't know, I'm making my third documentary. Y'all could be famous. This is the Stormville Deli behind here. They're really hiker friendly, always have been. You can camp back here, there's water, there's electricity, and really good food. Highly recommend a Stormville Deli. I've never tried the pizza place, I'm sure it's good too. Just four tents off the trail. I'm tempted just to stay here today. I really am. I mean, I don't know what I'm rushing for. I'm out here till September 3rd, and then I'm going probably to live in Tennessee this winter. Yeah, don't pass this place up. It's a must have, man. Must have.
I
want
to be a happy people real fast.
Yeah, okay.
It's Tuesday afternoon. This is the native landscape place. Can't camp here anymore, but it's still a great place to stop. You get water, you can buy sodas, you can charge up your stuff. So I recommend the Native Landscape Place by Pauline Newark. Well, I'm in Kent, Connecticut, one of my favorite towns. This nice lady every year lets us camp in her backyard. It's a woman's clothing store. Probably nothing in there that I would ever buy or most hikers would, but she still lets us stay here. That's what makes Kent so great. And what is your trail name?
We're Trial and Error.
And why are you hiking the AT?
I have a lot of rage.
Yeah. I'm doing it for the experience to see what's out there, right?
Cool. Well, thanks. Well, I'm at the Yellow Deli here in Rutland. It's the next morning. Slept like shit. I'm not used to sleeping on beds. Don't know what I'm going to do today. It's raining. Don't really want to go to Hanover in the rain. Oh, man. I need some medical. I need to be safe, and there's nowhere to get safe. Oh, man. Later.